Today I have the pleasure of speaking with Don from Avalon Advanced Materials. Don, how are you today?
Great to be back, Tracy.
Don, I want to start by congratulating you for winning PDAC's Distinguished Service Award, and I want to talk to you about that, but first I want to congratulate you with the news you just announced yesterday, where you provide an update on all three of your projects as you race towards small-scale production. So how about we start with that?
Yeah, we're making a lot of progress. We haven't had a tremendous amount of news flow over the last couple of months, but that's not because we haven't been working real hard. We're moving both all three projects forward with that goal of achieving initial small-scale production within the next year or so.
I continue to pound the issues of sustainability with our audience, and these critical materials we need for technology applications. So let's start with Nechalacha. What's happening there?
Well, as you know, we have a new partner there in Cheetah Resources, an Australian private company that shares our vision for the need for small-scale rapid production to serve this rapidly growing deficit in the market for rare earths as soon as possible. And so they have agreed to work with us on that project, and we actually have sold them one small part of it to allow them to take the lead on getting that going, with our support, of course, to help them get started and create long-term possibilities to grow that project.
And their investment is $5 million, is that correct?
That's the initial purchase price. Then they'll also be investing what's needed to take the project through the next stages of feasibility study work and put it in production.
And of course, let me ask what all anyone that understands and has been following Nechalacha really wants to know, which is, how did you get the Australians attracted to investing in the Northwest Territories?
Well, they saw our news release back in October, where we talked about the small-scale model and being able to take advantage of a resource there called the T-Zone, where we think it can be processed using very simple low-impact ore sorting technology. And it turned out they were thinking the same thing on other projects they're looking at right now. And so they approached us about collaborating. And we realized right away we have a like-minded partner here that would be good to work with on this project and see if we can establish a new precedent there, get it started as an opportunity to grow a business in the rare earths emerging sector.
And of course, it's kind of neck and neck for me about which update I would prefer next, either Ontario or Nova Scotia. But let's start with Nova Scotia. What's happening there?
Well, we've been working with Chronomet on actually the opportunity to apply ore sorting technology there as well. It's an exciting new technology that will make mineral processing much simpler, lower cost, and lower impact in terms of environmental impacts. And they see the opportunity to apply it there on that resource that would create efficiencies there. So we extracted a bulk sample with them in January. That's now en route to a plant in Europe for them to do some trial work on to prove up the process, define exactly how it can be best applied at East Kempville, and then go from there on finalizing the feasibility study work to implement it.
Okay, well, but let's talk a little bit more specifically about your project in Nova Scotia, tin-indium project. And not everybody out there may appreciate how this is involved even in the battery community.
Yeah, as you recall, it was recognized as the number one most impacted metal by new technology because of the many new applications being developed for it in lithium-ion battery technology, electronics, renewable energy, solar panels, etc. So there's lots of opportunity there for tin going forward to see growing demand. And that's where we see an opportunity to get that operation started again, clean up some of the waste materials that were left behind, extract value from that, and then see what else can be done there in the future to take advantage of that growing demand for tin.
So for all of you cannabis investors out there, with all your money that you're making, you're calling your friends, remember these technology metals are required for these applications, and you may want to diversify your portfolio. So let's talk about what's happening in Ontario.
So our lithium project now is getting a new lease on life because of a real shortage of supply of the lithium minerals that are needed in the glass and ceramics industry, where lithium is still a critical ingredient in high-strength glass products. And petalite has always been a preferred mineral source for the lithium to be used in those glass formulations. And it's in very short supply right now, so that's the opportunity you look for as an emerging new producer of a niche market material like that, is when you're the only real viable alternative supply source available to serve this new demand. That's the circumstance we're in right now. We've got new interest from strategic partners to work with us on that project.
So correct me if I'm wrong, but the real story here is that not only do we have three critical material projects, but you are moving them towards small scale production here in the next little while. And what should we as shareholders anticipate in the next quarter or two, Don? What's happening next?
Well, we hope to close a couple of deals that will provide us with the capital to move them forward more quickly to achieve that goal.
Well, Don, as always, thank you so much for joining us.
My pleasure.